Dear students, today we will be studying refrigeration system of a commercial dairy plant. So these are compressors. So here we are seeing a row of compressor is there. At this side we are having three booster compressors. So these three are booster compressors, and in between we are having other vessels, and this side we are having three main compressors. So these three booster compressors and main compressors are connected in series with each other. So here we can see some of the other vessels which are supporting this system are also there. Here we go on to one of the vessel in the starting. So this is called as low slope pot, as here you can see low slope pot is here. So this is the receiving side of the compressor, the booster compressors. So this particular line coming from this wall, this is carrying the vapor refrigerant from ice cream cold storages or deep freezers, and it is carried via these lines to this pot. This is one of the vessels. So this is for a low slope pot electrical connection. Here at this side we can see this yellow line which is coming from the liquid receiver of the ammonia tank, and this red line which is coming from this particular side, this is coming from the discharge side of the compressor. So basically this pipeline is used for vaporization of the ammonia if it is received in liquid form from this compressor, and this evaporator unit will be supplying the liquid ammonia. So at the back end we can see this particular pipeline which is supplying this vapor ammonia coming from the evaporator side. It will be going from this particular part into the system. Then at this side here we can see this is the electrical connection which will be connected by this electrical socket here. This will be used for evaporation of liquid ammonia if it is received in this low slope pot, and it will do the vaporization of the ammonia, and that will be sent to the suction side of the booster compressors. So here we are seeing one yellow line. This yellow line is for the liquid ammonia. If it is there in the system low slope pot, then it can be taken out by using this yellow colored line. Other lines which are connected to this vessel are this red line. It is coming from the discharge end of the booster compressor. So this will be also used for heating of the liquid ammonia if it is received. These two other connections will be connected to the level indicator. So level indicator will be used for measurement of liquid level. So here we are seeing this particular line. This is going to the suction side of this booster compressor here. So here this suction line has come to this port. So this is the suction manifold of the system. So this suction manifold will be receiving the vapor ammonia from the low slope pot supplied to the compressor, and from here it will be supplied to the two cylinders. So here we are having two cylinders. So both cylinders will be connected to this common suction manifold via these pipelines, and these two are the cylinder, one at this side, another at that side. This is the discharge manifold. So here we can see a better view from this side. And this discharge manifold is also having this valve. So this is the discharge control valve, and these are the two cylinders. So this compressor is KC2 type, and this brown line which we saw was for oil. And this is the induction motor along with this flywheel covered in this net. So coming on to the other part, we can see this discharge line which is exiting from this compressor is entering to this device here. So this cylindrical part is the oil separator, and from this oil separator it is exiting going to the next component. So this is the oil separator, and this is the line from where it is entering this oil separator at this part. and this brown colored line, oil which is used for lubrication of compressor, that will be supplied by using this pipeline back to the compressor from the oil separator. So this is the pipeline going back to the compressor. Then we are seeing these gauges. So this is the high pressure gauge, means discharge side. This is low pressure gauge, suction side. This is oil pressure gauge for measurement and monitoring of the pressures on the three different sides of the compressor. And here we are having control panel with this particular meter. So this is counting how many hours it has worked. Now coming on to the other side, here we are seeing this red colored line, which is common to all these three booster compressor, is going to this vessel here. So this is basically an intercooler called as LG intercooler, L for liquid, G for gas. And this LG cooler function is to intercool two different fluids. One will be the compressed ammonia gas which is coming from the booster compressor, and also to cool the ammonia which is going to the ice cream deep freezer. So basically this is a pressure vessel which is open from inside and it is having coils. So this yellow colored line which is entering from this bottom port is coiled inside and getting out from this side here. So here we can see insulated line with this yellow colored part protruding out of here, and this yellow colored line, this is coming from the ammonia receiver. So this ammonia receiver line, which will be circulating the liquid ammonia which is required to go to the ice cream deep freezer, it will be coiled inside and having a indirect heat transfer from the evaporation of the liquid ammonia inside. One more liquid ammonia line will be supplied to this LG cooler so as to have evaporative cooling and subcool this liquid ammonia going to the ice cream deep freezer, and hence this line will be at a temperature lower than ambient and hence it is insulated. So here we are seeing this particular line, this yellow colored line, this is coming from the receiver and it is going via this part at this side, and via this pipeline connection it is entering into this LG cooler, and it is subdivided into two parts. One line is going at the bottom, another line which is supplying to cool this another part of refrigerant here. So this was for subcooling of the ammonia. This line is incoming from the booster compressor, and then this ammonia line will be also required to be cooled so that it has to go to the next compression cycle and temperature should reduce. So this particular line here, you can see this line is going to this connection, and this connection will go finally to the main compressor. Coming on to the back side of LG cooler, here we are seeing this yellow colored line entering at this side. So this is from where the evaporation will be happening. And at this side, we are seeing these pipelines. This central pipeline, this is from the milkfold storages, and it is going to the high slope pot via this connection. So high slope pot and low slope pot both are the receiving devices. So this is the high slope pot backside. This is electrical connection for heating the liquid ammonia, if any, and here is the liquid level indicator of this high slope pot. At this side we can see the connections, how they are entering and how they are exiting. From the top side, the vapor ammonia will be exiting, and this line will be going to the suction side of this main compressor. So this is the suction line going to the main compressor here. So here we are having four cylinder compressor, two cylinder on this side, another two cylinder on other side. This is the discharge side of this compressor, and the manifold is in this U-turn type of shape. So this is the discharge manifold at the top, this is the suction manifold at the bottom. This side, this is the suction manifold. And here we can see the complete view of this compressor at this end. So this is the flywheel and induction motor for this main compressor. So this is KC4 type of compressor, and this is its control panel with its hour meter. So here we can see H for hour. So how many hours it has worked, it will be recording that, so that we can plan the maintenance accordingly, that after so many working hours it has to be going for the maintenance purpose. Now coming on to the condenser side. So here we can see this pipeline, this insulated pipeline coming out of the main compressor, then it is going towards this side here, So here at this side, this connection is going to a cassette type PHE in which this refrigerant is going, which is having a very high temperature, and this is an energy saving initiative done by this dairy plant in which the boiler feed water is getting preheated by use of this PHE, and the water which will be preheated will take some of the heat of this refrigerant and the refrigerant will cool down a bit. So this refrigerant will be coming down via this pipeline and preheated water will then go to the boiler feed tank. In between we are having this valve here. So this valve is a bypass valve. If this PHE is required to be out of circuit, then this valve can be opened and other two valves which will be on the top side can be closed, and if it is required to be going through this PHE, then it has to be closed and other two top valves can be opened. Now after this PHE, it will be going to this condenser. So from here at the bottom side, we can see that this line is going to this condenser. We are having a shell and tube type of condenser at this dairy plant. So following this red line is coming at this point here. So this is the shell and tube type of vertical condenser. Here we can see this name here, and this line is going to this one condenser here, and another condenser is on the back side, so it will be going to that side also. So in this shell and tube type of condenser, we are having vertical tubes. Tube side we will be having cooling water, and on the shell side we will be having refrigerant. So refrigerant will be cooled by using cold water from the cooling tower, and cold water is open to air, open to atmosphere, so it will be carrying away the latent heat of vaporization of that refrigerant. Refrigerant will cool down, get liquefied, collected at the bottom in the shell side and discharged from this yellow colored line from the dischargent at this side here. Now coming on to the top side of this condenser, we can see that how this condenser will be working. Now before going to this top side, we can see this view here. So we are having these pumps here. So these pumps are sucking the water from this condenser sump and supplying to the cooling tower. So this is the main suction manifold from this condenser for the cooling tower, and the discharge line is connected to the discharge manifold, which is connected at the back side to these cooling towers. So we are having many cooling towers here. So this here we can see the fan is blowing the air out. This is an evaporative type of cooling tower in which the water will be coming in the gravity flow from top to bottom, and air will be sucked by this fan from the back side of this cooling tower towards the front side. So this cooling tower will be evaporating some amount of water. That water will be taking the latent heat of evaporation from rest of the water, the water which is falling in the liquid form, and getting the water cooled. So this is how it will be cooling, and from the back side we can see the structure. At the back side we are having honeycomb type of structure from where the air will be entering. So this is a cross flow type of cooling tower. So this is the direction of flow of water in the vertical direction, and these two cooling towers here, these are the counter flow cooling towers in which we are having one fan at the top side which will be sucking the air from bottom to top, and water will be falling from top to bottom. So it will be a counter flow type of arrangement with honeycomb structure to increase the area from where heat and mass transfer can take place. Now here we are seeing these pipelines connected at this discharge manifold of this cooling tower, and this discharge manifold of cooling tower is connected to this pump, and these pumps are then pumping this cold water to the condenser unit situated at this side. So by following this line we can see that these pipelines are rising to the top and then distributed onto both sides. So this is the top side of this condenser. So here we are seeing the tubes in which the water will be entering. So this is an overflow weir which is in circular shape. So this pipeline from the back side is supplying the cold water from the cooling tower. Cold water will be coming here, and by overflowing it will enter to this compartment. In this compartment we are having these swirl inserts. So these swirl inserts are having some swirl kind of arrangements. So I will be showing you one of them, so that the swirl this pipeline here, we can see this pipeline is having these swirls. So these swirls will be initiating a flow of water in a helical form. So the tube with on top of which the swirl insert is placed, the water while entering that tube will be given a rotational motion, and due to that rotational motion, water will be entering and flowing inside in that circular motion, so that it will be having an increase in time of residence, so that more heat transfer can take place, as well as it will be maintaining the close contact with the tube's heat transfer surface area. So the water is not required to be flowing full in the tubes, it has to be in close contact with the heat transfer area. So both of them can be ensured by this swirl insert here. So this is placed like this on the top of the tube, and tubes are open to air from both top and bottom. This is the bottom side. At the bottom, this is how the water will be falling in the sump, and we can then have collection of water at the sump and discharge to the cooling tower. These two yellow lines are for collecting the liquid ammonia from both of the condensers and taking it to receiver. So here at the bottom side, we can see liquid ammonia line from the bottom of the condenser, and these liquid lines will be merging together forming into one single line, and via this trench it is going to this receiver tank here. So this is the liquid ammonia receiver. So in this liquid ammonia receiver, we are having this pipeline entering into the receiver, and this another yellow colored pipeline here at this side exiting from the receiver. So this yellow colored line here, which is exiting from the receiver, will go up to the bottom of this receiver so that it can suck only the liquid part and not the vapor part, if any. So this liquid line will be supplying the liquid ammonia, and this line will be sucking of liquid ammonia to the required evaporator. This is the pressure gauge, and these are some of the safety valves, and we can see other lines as well from here. So this pipeline, this red colored pipeline here, which is going to this side at the farther away unit, that is air purger. So this red colored cylinder here, this is air purger, and this yellow colored line here, which is entering to this side of the wall, this is going to the inside or to LG cooler also. So we will be having this insulated line coming out, so this insulated line and this yellow colored line here. So these two lines, one of this yellow colored line, one another this insulated line, these two are carrying the liquid ammonia. This yellow colored line will be having liquid ammonia at ambient temperatures, and this insulated line will be having ammonia at subcooled temperature for ice cream deep freezer. So this yellow colored line will be going to milk cold storages, and this insulated line will be going to the other cold storages like ice cream and other frozen dairy products.